Oh, it's Nitro 99 again. I'll be doing a review on the London Escape, Pirates of the Caribbean, on Stranger Tides, 463 pieces. This set cost $50, and it comes with 5 minifigures. Several of them are new, and they're all actually great figures. I'm just going to say right now that this set is a very good set. It actually complements other themes quite nicely, so it's a set you should probably get. But anyway, onto the set. First, we get the card, because it's on Stranger Tides. Get Josh Mee Gibbs. And for some reason, this set did not come with cardboard backing on the manual. I don't know why these random sets get cardboard for some reason. I'm not sure why. It's pretty strange. And also, the new gold pieces in the baggie, I kept them in the baggie just to show our friends in Europe, because they're not getting this, because Lego's gay for some reason. I don't know why the European people don't get the new gold, but Americans do, and it goes back in the treasure chest. But onto the set. Here is Josh Mee Gibbs. I have him gave him a rifle so he can fight back. He's usually in handcuffs. Here's his handcuffs. And I haven't seen the movie yet, but I can only guess that Johnny Depp has to rescue Mr. Gibbs, because from the King George's soldiers, redcoats. That's what it says on the box. But he's really nice. He has a nice beard. And he's also like, whoa! And a new hairpiece in dark gray, blay, or whatever it's called, bluish gray. He's a nice figure. Here's Johnny Depp. Lego's pretty smart. They put the give you the Johnny Depps with hats in the more expensive sets. So you can't get both. And he's completely different than the other one. Actually, let me grab regular Johnny Depp. Here. Just to give you a comparison. Completely different. He's wearing his coat. And I really like his hat. His hat does not come off, though. It's a headpiece. And his face is the same as in the other sets, except where he's special. He's a nice figure. I really like this Johnny Depp. Jack Sparrow. Here we get a cart horse driver. The head is the same from the Prince of Persia line. New torso. Hat's the same. Back printing on the torso. But nice torso. Nice period piece torso there. Here we get a red coat. The red coat is pretty much the same as other pirate sets. New hat with the white rim on it. And here is a new red coat. An officer, Indiana Jones. I knew this theme was close to Indiana Jones. Fountain of Youth, this, Indiana Jones, yeah. But just a head. He has a sheath. Torso is very nice. Gold epaulette. And he looks very nice. Here's the set. One of the carts is this little coal cart that catches on fire. It has a play feature where you change it, but I guess you can revolve around. But it catches on fire. Comes a shovel. Of course. Looks like that one is on fire. That's okay. It's a bag number two. The first bag, you build this big cart. And like I was saying, this can transition into other themes like kingdoms. This is Dragon Knight's colors, the green and black. So you could use this for kingdoms as well. And of course, the pub over there is perfect for a medieval market village or kingdoms. So this is a good set. Especially since in the new kingdom set you get a carriage for the lion knights, but now you can get one for the dragon knights, for their king. The play feature up here is this moves up, and yeah, it works kind of, you know. There. It works pretty well, but I mean, I don't know. I'm not seeing many kids wanting to play that. At least I wouldn't. So not much to say about the carriage. This functionality up here is nice. And, oh yeah, opening the doors either side. You just sit a figure in there. One figure. Here we have the pub. Like I said, this would work well with Medieval Market Village. You can shut it out like this. You can do that. Do that. And of course the barrels fell out. Sorry. It's a kind of a dumb play feature. You have these barrels and you stick them in there. And then you're supposed to rip this out so the barrels were out. It doesn't work that well. But as I was showing, there's a printed piece here. It's called The Captain's Daughter. It's hard to show up because it's very faint. This opens up for some reason. Not sure why. Up here is a sexophant. These new window doors. It's wood. Printed piece of a boat. Very nice. It's printed. A rat. And a new bucket. New piece for this theme. It's a bucket. And for some reason there's a giant tarantula in the set, which makes no sense because England does not have big spiders like this. Especially since it's as big as the rat. It's like a bird-eating spider. So that doesn't make any sense. It shouldn't even be in the set. You also get a beer keg. You've seen that in Medieval Market Village. Simple design. And you get a table with some bottles. These do not have printed on it like the boat. And that's pretty much it. Next we have the big poster. Poster is humongous. I haven't opened the poster yet. Oh my gosh, this poster is bigger than I thought. Oh my god. I'll probably just show you it in the manual because it's that big. It's basically a giant action shot of what's going on, but let me show it to you in the manual because it shows all the posters. Manual number one. They have two manuals. That's the poster. And it's humongous. And it's really humongous. Anyway, that's it. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and see you later. Bye.